So, now that we have our EQ, if we have a rate constraint, that is QW is fixed or prescribed, then we'll evaluate the pressure at the well at the radius of the well for PREF equal to PL and RF equal to REQ, which we now have an equation for. And if we do that, then we have pressure at the well that guy. And then often what we do is we call this term here, that's equal to 1 over the productivity index or well index for the Lth grid block. And so the way you would write, seeing this written often, is that this is equal to PL plus QW over JLW. So in the event that you have a constant rate well, as we'll see in a second, that the QW just ends up going into your Q vector on the right-hand side of your equations, and then you solve for PL, and in the solution process, and then you can solve for the pressure at the well. Right. So this is something you sort of post-process. If you, once you have a solution of the equations, you know PL, you know QW, you can compute the well index, and then you can compute the pressure at the well, the bottom hole pressure. Right. So if we have a pressure constraint, like a constant bottom hole pressure well, then in this case PW is fixed or prescribed, then we need to solve for QW. And so if we do that, we have QW is equal to or again, where J at the Lth grid block for a well is this is called, again, productivity index, or sometimes called the well index. Also, sometimes you'll see an additional little fudge factor placed here. This is called the skin factor. And that is a sort of artificial term, a way to account for certain completions, like possibly hydraulic fracturing or acidization or some way you treated the well, or possibly also formation damage. So, going back to our discrete equations, again, we had some B matrix, again, before time discretization, dP dt. P, again, is the vector of unknown pressures for the grid blocks. So now Q, and we'll ignore any other boundary conditions, but we'll just look, just talk about wells for now. Right? The Q vector is a zero vector, essentially, except in locations where there are wells. Right? So we'll just write little q at L. For a well in the Lth grid block. And of course you could have multiple wells. So you could, if you had, you know, wells in the fifth, sixth, seventh grid blocks, then those would just go in the fifth, sixth, seventh locations there. And so then, again, just repeating, for a constant rate well, Q at L is equal to QW, right? So it's, you know, where what goes into the Q vector at that location is simply the rate constraint, the operating rate, whether it's an injector or producer, at which you're going to operate the well. For a pressure constraint, then Q at L is equal to minus J at L, PL minus P at the well. Right? So we're P at the well in a pressure constrained well, P at the well is known, J at the well is the productivity index, which you can compute. And of course, P at L is what you're solving for. So now you have an unknown, You have an unknown on the right-hand side of the equation there. And so what you end up with then, this is negative, but what happens then is the negative JLPL, we move back to the left-hand side of the equation because it's an unknown, and then you have minus PW, and that stays on the right-hand side of the equation. So then we modify our discrete equations to include this productivity index term. That equals Q, where, again, Q is now a vector of, and I'll just include, say, a place where you have a constant pressure boundary condition, so or this would be a prescribed pressure boundary condition, possibly some zeros, and then if you had a well in a certain location that was a constant bottom hole pressure well, you'd have a J, let's say P, PW, and then here you'd have a Q, Q. Well, I don't want to confuse you. I don't have QQ, but let's say J, N, QM. So where this comes from would be a constant bottom hole pressure well in the nth block. And this would be a constant rate well in the nth block. So something like that. So then just to be clear, what goes in this J matrix is, J is a diagonal matrix. So J, the J matrix, is a diagonal matrix where there's zeros everywhere except for where there's a well, right? So in that case, there's the JN term associated with the nth grid block, right? And it zeros everywhere else. So, and of course, there could be multiple ones. There could be additional wells too there. So then just to reiterate, therefore, for an implicit formulation, then you have the set of discrete equations that is a T matrix plus a J matrix plus 1 over delta T times a B matrix, all times the pressure at the N plus 1 time step, equal to 1 over delta T B times the pressure at the nth time step plus the Q vector. And so then to solve this for P N plus 1, you'd invert the left-hand side here. So everything we talked about now, there, you know, we had quite a few assumptions in there: homogeneous, isotropic, regular discretization. We can extend these ideas to